This episode of DNews is brought to you by Audible. The CDC was just caught using expired disinfectant in their labs, which got me thinking, disinfectant expires? What? Howdy gang, Trace here with some DNews for you. The CDC's use of expired cleanser was discovered after 75 employees were accidentally exposed to live anthrax last month, and the USDA stepped in to look at their procedures to see who screwed up. Most labs use bleach as their disinfectant because the active ingredient, hypochlorous acid, causes the proteins in bacteria to unfold and the bacteria to die. Bleach is what was being used by the CDC in their labs, and it has an expiration date of only 6 months from the date of manufacture, so like 3 to 5 months once you get it home. It expires because the sodium hypochlorite decomposes over time. The cooler the storage area, the better, but bleach manufactured and stored in the summer months will degrade faster. Expiration dates are used by manufacturers not to tell you it's time to throw this away, but more to say we can't guarantee that this product is perfect anymore. The dates are usually printed on the product, and there are lots and lots of them. The latex in a condom has an expiration date of 5 years because the latex needs to be moist. And after 5 years, the brand can't guarantee the latex hasn't degraded from drying. If it has spermicide, that life is even shorter. It's only 3 years. Like with bleach, spermicide's active ingredient degrades over time. Sunscreen also expires, mainly because the tiny particles inside the solution clump together as the sunscreen ages. This decreases the effectiveness and causes the sunscreen to eventually become crappy. Mascara expires after 2 or 3 months. So if you're gonna splurge on that fancy lash lengthening formula, use it all. Why? Because your eyes are dirty. And once it's been used, the mascara becomes a breeding ground for bacteria. After the date, the bacteria could have built up enough to cause eye infections like conjunctivitis or pink eye. And you should definitely get rid of your loofah after 3 to 4 weeks. Bacteria, folks, it's growing on your stuff. Other than bacteria, it's all about the active ingredients. Anti-acne creams usually break down within 3 months of first opening, sometimes sooner if they're natural. Hair gel and hairspray last 2 to 3 years. Soap usually expires in 18 months to 2 years, especially if it contains essential oils. Soap is made of lye, which is a generic term for an alkaline solution, and a collection of fats. So over time, the lye gets less potent and the fats degrade. Are you sensing a pattern here? It's not just bathroom stuff, though. Motor oil is organic. It used to be tiny plants and animals, remember? Fossil fuels? Like all the other things, once it's open, the air begins to break it down, and after 90 days, it's expired. Unopened, it might last 5 years. Alkaline batteries last 5 years too, and the chemicals inside the batteries will only hold a charge for so long. Because their elements are different, lithium batteries can last as long as 10 years. There are a lot of things with expiration dates, and while you might not have to pay attention to them all the time, the CDC bleach, by the way, would still be okay if it was maybe 9 months after manufacture, but every month more, the acid is depleted, and then eventually it doesn't work. Hopefully the CDC will pony up for some new cleaner, and so should you. Kind of makes those trips to Costco to buy 100 soaps seem kind of silly, doesn't it? There are two things that I found that never expire, by the way, honey and nail polish remover. Yeah, so that's good to know, I guess. What other things have surprising shelf lives? Tell us yours below, and if you love exploring your world as much as we do, then check out audible.com. They've got hours of audiobooks on space, biology, history, and more. But if you like listening to people talk about the world, then try The Autobiography of Mark Twain, Volume 1. It was incredible. He dictated that whole book back in 1904, so it's like listening to him talk to you, literally. Double meaning. You can find this and 100,000 other audiobooks on Audible and download a free book of your choice by going to audiblepodcast.com/dnews. Check it out and please subscribe for more DNews every day of the week. Thanks for watching.